Want to see how to hang a gate? Full disclosure, I have been hanging my other gates wrong. This gate slopes down this way. Originally, this two-way goat, That's a good one, Brian. It's a two-way gate. Deciding where to put your gates obviously depends on your own setup. This gate is going right here for easy access to this shed. This space has another gate, so we can easily segregate goats in this space if we need to, but it'll also be nice to keep the goats out when I need to cart in bales of hay or other supplies. Once you know where your gates are going, you can decide how big they should be, as well as on which side they should hinge. We're going with 4-foot gates because that's easy enough to get a wheelbarrow through. And this gate will hinge on this side. That way, when it's open, it won't get in the way of the wheelbarrow. How high off the ground should your gate be? It just needs to open easily and not have enough room underneath for your animals to escape. This area is pretty flat, so that makes it a little easier. Let's take a look at a couple of our older gates. This one has a slight slope down that direction, but it really hasn't been an issue for us. This gate slopes down this way. Originally, this gate could open inside. Now it hits on the inside. It's a good thing to keep in mind that the ground level can change over time, either through erosion or something just as simple as adding bark mulch. Hanging a gate is fairly self-explanatory. Let's see if I can just show you how to do it rather than explaining every step. I will show you close-ups of the tools and hardware that I'm using. Speaking of tools, and this has nothing to do with gates, I wanted to congratulate my oldest nephew, Jagan. He just became a homeowner for the first time. I've set aside some tools to give him. You know how it is with tools. You have your own. Maybe your dad gives you some others. In my case, I also inherited a little bit when my grandfather and my uncle passed away. So these are all duplicates. It'll be nice to have a little more room in the barn shed, and it'll feel good to keep these in the family. Before we just jump right in, there's a couple things I wanted to explain. Because the latch is flat, and the posts are round, we've positioned these posts close enough so that they will require a little bit of woodworking to recess the latch back into the post. That'll give it a flat surface, and I just think it looks a little better. These latch kits do not come with screws to mount them to the post. You'll have to get those separately. Full disclosure, I have been hanging my other gates wrong. These guys look like they just screw into the post, and then the gate just sits right down on both of them. But instead of doing it that way, the top pin should be angled downward, locking that gate firmly into place. We have never had a problem with animals lifting a gate off of these pins. Maybe it's because our gates are small. When they're closed, there's just no way this gate is coming off those pins. Am I going to change all these gates to point those pins down? No, not unless we actually have a problem with them. I'm embarrassed and more than a little angry with myself. I accidentally deleted all of the video of me hanging this gate. It was gonna be cool. I was gonna show a close-up of each tool and part just before cutting to showing them in use, all without dialogue and set to some relaxing music. Well, this is a how-to video, so maybe some extra explaining isn't a bad thing. Start by cinching these two pieces where you want them with a socket wrench. Then mark on the post where your pilot holes need to go. That step is helpful if you have somebody to assist you, somebody who can hold the gate while you make your marks. This is the bit that I used for those pilot holes. It's of course thinner than the threads of the screws. I prefer using my corded drill just because it has more power than my cordless one does. If you have someone to help you, they can hold a 2x4 across the two posts so you can easily judge how to drill your holes so that they're parallel with the fence line. Some drills have a little bubble level on them, so you know that it's level with the ground before you start drilling. I do have some video from another gate that shows a good trick of using a wrench to tighten in these pins. You cinched this in place earlier so you know where to put the pin. To put the gate on, you'll need to loosen this so it can drop down. The gate will then fit over this pin, and this will slip up into that pin before tightening it down again. This is how the latch system looks when it's done. The bar needs to just hit somewhere in the middle there. I'll take this apart so you can see a little better how this part of the latch is put together. There's a J-shaped insert that fits in here so you can really tighten it down. On this part of the latch, there's a round hole and a square hole. The square hole lines up with the square end of the bolt. It's important when you're putting this little J insert in there to match the round hole with that round hole. We ended up using only one of those J inserts. This little bar right here prevented the bolt from going through if that J insert was in there. So we opted just not to use it. I could have used my Sawzall and cut this little piece out so that second insert could be in there. You of course want this part of the latch to span the crossbar. Once this part of the latch is on, you can hold the main latching part of the latch against the post so that the bar hits in the right place and draw pencil lines at the top and bottom. At that point, you also measure to see how far into the post you need to go. Most guys might use a chainsaw to make short work of the next step. I wanted a little more control, and I didn't mind taking my time to chisel out just exactly what I needed. I just used a handsaw to cut right above and below those pencil lines. Then I just chiseled out between the two cuts. Because of the configuration of this latch, you'll need an extension for your socket wrench. It's also helpful to have a longer than normal drill bit to do the pilot holes. If, like me, you prefer to put in one screw at a time before drilling the next pilot hole. You could just trace out the holes and very carefully drill all of the pilot holes to start with. At the end, you have a very satisfying clank of a locked gate just by swinging it closed from either side. hanging a gate isn't something that you just do once and then forget about it. You probably will have to do a little maintenance from time to time. These bolts seem to need tightening every now and then just to keep things square and working right. If by any chance this bar isn't quite hitting right, it may be helpful to take the gate off and then either lengthen or shorten one or both of those pins. Maybe just a turn or two would make a little bit of a difference. Let's take a look at some of our older gates that have required more extensive interventions. This gate has been here for quite a while. We've just recently put in the permanent fencing around it. Before that, we had a temporary electric net style fence extending out from either side and around their enclosure. These cross braces, when they went in, they squeezed the posts together, and this bar was hitting, not letting the gate close. This pin has already been tightened all the way it can be, so I couldn't correct it that way. I only had two choices: either recess this latch back into the post or just cut a little bit off of that bar. We opted to just cut a little bit off the bar. The posts on this gate are leaning away from each other. The bar was just barely catching that latch. It needed to be shimmed. Shimming is pretty easy. You just take the latch off and cut a piece of wood to fit that's the right thickness, then drill holes in that shim to get the holes in the right place. You just hold the latch firmly and drill right through the holes. These are not pilot holes. I wanted the threads of those old screws to easily slide through, so when I reattached it, I could find and use the original thread grooves. How, you might ask, do I work on a gate and not let our goats out in the process? I'll show you. Let's show a close-up. This will keep the goats in there for a little while, but it doesn't keep them from being really curious about what you're doing. So I also gave them some branches to eat over on the other side of their enclosure. Goats are always ever so helpful.